Hello everyone, I'm Alisha and welcome to the Google Play Policy Bytes India video series. In this series, we talk about Google Play policies that guide you as you build apps and games for users worldwide. These are the policies that make sure your apps are safe for millions of people around the world. In the next set of videos, we will be addressing key topics that are relevant for Indian developers to help learn more about how to build sustainable businesses on Google Play. We aim to cover the frequently asked questions we receive on some key policies while also giving you some tips and tricks along the way. In the next few videos, we will cover these topics: login credentials policy, store listing and promotions policy, user-generated content, families policy, and intellectual property. These videos will also be available on Google Developers India YouTube channel, How Play Works India website, and Made for India Play Academy module. In this video, we will show you some common violations we have encountered about login credentials and share details on how to avoid them. Let's start with taking a look at some examples of common policy violations we have come across as developers submit their app for review. First is regarding the expired credentials. This happens when the username that you have provided is not working or is invalid. To resolve this, you will need to submit new credentials that are not expired so that the team can review your app. Sometimes developers provide us with non-English login credentials and use special characters for the name, username, or password. To address this, please submit an English language version of all necessary details regarding the login credentials. Next is account setup. Sometimes our app reviewers are blocked by account setup completion prompts like the example here. Note that you have to make your app available for review by submitting new credentials that do not require account setup. Our next example shows an app that asks to complete security steps. For example, setting a PIN code to complete a login process. If this is the case, remember to provide all instructions and access details via the instructions field in the Play console so that the team can review the app. Another example is an app that asks for a one-time password or activation code. For this, you will need to provide reusable login credentials that do not expire. Kindly note that Google Play reviewers are unable to receive one-time passwords or activation codes. Next example shows an app access via a third-party site, which is denied. If this is the case for your app, you need to provide the login credentials to third-party sites or provide other ways to access the app. Next example shows non-numeric login credentials. If access to in-app content requires non-numerical login details, such as QR code, barcode, or physical card, do provide a valid static URL image of your non-numerical login details. Moving on to demo accounts. In this example, you need to purchase the app, sign up for a trial period or subscription, or enter credit card details to access in-app features. For this, remember to provide access details to the demo account that doesn't require payment or payment details for Google Play team to review the app. Another example is when login credentials are restricted to a specific location or geographical region. To resolve this issue, remember to provide credentials that are valid regardless of location. Our next example is about biometric authentication, such as requiring face scans, fingerprints, or photos to access in-app content. To resolve this, you will need to provide other ways to access in-app content as Google Play reviewers cannot provide their own biometrics. Last but not least, this app requires the user to input hardware device information or vehicle details to access in-app content. Please note that you will need to provide credentials and all other necessary details for Google Play reviewers to access your app. Moving on to helpful tips. One area where we have seen a noticeable concern is missing login credentials for apps with vault content. We want to clarify that if your apps have login vaults, you need to provide accurate login credentials through the Play console. Remember, before you submit your app, you must provide an active demo account, login information, and all other resources needed to review your app in the Policy app content page of the Play console. If you have already provided the same in the past, be sure to double check to see if they're still valid and working. And also ensure that your contact information is correct to get the recent updates and important notices from us. We've seen a lot of developers missing key communication from Google Play because of incorrect or outdated contact details. Moving on to best practices. Take note that you can add up to 5 sets of instructions. Here are some important things to remember when adding instructions for app access. If your login credentials are not numeric or alphanumeric, for example, a QR code or barcode, generate a static URL and upload it to Play Console. If your app typically requires a 2-step verification code or 1-time password, provide us with reusable login credentials that do not expire or share detailed instructions to access your app. If your app normally uses a location-dependent password, do provide login credentials that are valid, regardless of user location. For example, master login credentials. If your login credentials are typically in a non-English language, provide an English language version of all necessary login credentials via Play Console. And here is how to add instructions for app access. First, open the Play Console and go to the app content page. Under App Access, select Start. Select All or some functionality is restricted. Click Add New Instructions and provide your access details. You can utilize any other instructions field to let us know if there is anything special about your login mechanism, such as using a one-time password, multi-factor authentication, or login with more than 2 fields. Then, save your changes. If your update is rejected or your app is removed due to this policy violation, please update your app access information and then resubmit your app for review. You can complete these steps without contacting or waiting for a reply from the policy support team. We hope you found this video useful and have learned more about our login credentials policy. Be sure to use the links in the description to explore other policy-related videos. Also, do check out the free courses on Google Play Policy and remember to visit our Google Play Academy. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay safe and stay healthy.